today, there are few areas of life where glass is not used in some way. The windows of houses, cars, ships, trains, and even airplanes are made from glass. The list of glass products is practically endless, from water vessels, tumblers, bottles, and sunglasses, to spectacles, flasks, lab items, incandescent bulbs, fluorescent tubes, and hundreds of other items from daily life. But how is this incredibly useful material made? Although glass has a plethora of applications, it is also mysterious, likely due to its strange chemical and physical behavior. It is strong enough to protect us, but can also shatter into thousands of pieces. Perhaps most startling of all, it appears and behaves like a solid, but it's actually a weird liquid in disguise. This might be hard to believe, but glass is made from liquid sand. More specifically, glass is made by heating ordinary sand until it melts and turns into a liquid. The melting point of sand is very high, around 1700 degrees Celsius. When the molten sand is allowed to cool, it doesn't return to its gritty, original state. The heating causes it to undergo a complete chemical transformation. Regardless of the techniques employed in cooling the molten sand, it never quite sets into a traditional solid. Instead, it turns into a frozen liquid or an amorphous solid. Glass is more like a cross between a solid and a liquid, featuring crystalline structures generally found in solids, as well as some molecular randomness commonly seen in liquids. Now that you understand the basics of making glass, let's look at how glass is made in an industrial situation. In an industrial glass plant, sand is mixed with waste glass pieces, often collected from recycling, limestone, and soda ash, before being heated in a furnace. The soda ash is added to reduce the sand's melting point, in a bid to save energy in the manufacturing process. However, this also has an unwanted side effect. It produces a type of glass that would dissolve in water. To counter this, limestone is added to the mixture. The end product obtained is called soda-lime-silica glass, which is the general-purpose glass we commonly see around us. In a bid to make different types of glass, commercial glass manufacturers often use slightly different glass manufacturing processes. This change often comes through adding other chemicals. For example, chromium or iron-based chemicals are added to the molten sand mixture to make green-tinted glass, whereas mixing in cobalt salt produces blue glass. To make oven-proof glass, boron oxide is added to the molten mixture. Highly specialized and super strong variants of glass, such as bulletproof or tempered glass, is made through a different manufacturing process. Sandwiching multiple layers of glass and plastic is done to make bulletproof glass. Tempered glass, used in car windshields, is usually made by cooling molten glass very rapidly to make it much harder. Basically, glass is clear, clean, cheap, unreactive, strong, and endlessly useful. It is one of those magic materials that we absolutely take for granted, but it perennially serves the purpose it's intended for, provided you use it with care.